Premier League Hall of Fame, John Terry, has to be. And now it is.
Wow, that's quite emotional. Sorry. Might have to edit that. I'm quite nervous. Oh my God, that's the worst picture. This is a picture of me from the old Harlington days. I just knew that I wanted to be a professional footballer.
17-year-old John Terry, a debut for him. Young man from Barking, who was wanted by Manchester United and who chose Chelsea instead.
So my brother played for Charlton for a couple of years. He didn't get his pro contract at the end of a two-year YTS. And kind of seeing the upset and the disappointment from him kind of just enabled me to give it absolutely everything. From the age of 14, Man United wanted to sign me. So it kind of come around that, would I sign for Man United or Chelsea? My dad was a big Man United fan growing up as well, so he was desperate for me to sign for Man United. And the moment I walked in at Chelsea, I felt like I was home. I know that sounds really strange for a young 14-year-old boy then to say it, but I just knew that Chelsea was the right club for me. Well, very special. My first Premier League medal, 2004-05.
Wonderful equaliser by the Chelsea captain! Oh, and yes they can, because it's Didier Drogba!
Frank Lampard, round the keeper, into the back of the net!
That's an emotional one for me, actually, seeing that. The first one in 50 years that Chelsea won it, so something that's very close to me.
John Terry emerges from the crowd to lift the trophy. The men from the King's Road.
We were so solid defensively. 15 goals is the record, obviously, still today. And I don't think it's one that will ever be beaten. I certainly hope it's not.
We should not be afraid to say we want to win. Please don't call me arrogant, because what I'm saying is true. I think I'm a special one.
When Jose first signed for Chelsea, he was quite infamous with that kind of press conference that he first took. And kind of got the players on edge a little bit. We were all nervous coming back pre-season, but once we got in, we see what a man he was and what a great coach he was as well. So just inspired us to be the best individuals we could be, actually. But what people didn't see was how personable he was with relationships with myself, with my kids, my family and all of that early on. So very important, and the best manager that I've ever worked with. A mobile phone.
Premier League Hall of Fame, John Terry, has to be, and now it is. I believe that for your kids, it's something really fantastic. For me, as one of the guys that had the privilege to work with you for about 6 seasons, I'm very proud. Your career was amazing. You were part of a changing in the history of the Premier League. And what can I say? I'm so happy for you and so proud of this achievement. Kisses, mate.
Wow. That's quite emotional. Sorry. I think I owe him a huge amount for my career and the kind of direction it went in along the way. But he was such a big influence, both on the pitch and off the pitch, for me. He still frightens me to death. When I see a video of him or he FaceTimes me out of the blue and stuff like that. But I've just got so much respect for him, of what he's done for me and Chelsea. Chelsea means everything to me. So, yeah, very emotional.
You refer to yourself as a special one. Are you still a special one?
I'm the happy one.
Being honest, if it wasn't Mourinho coming back to the football club, I think my time at Chelsea would have been up, which is difficult to say because Chelsea had... It was all I knew from a very young age. But yeah, I was probably being forced out of the football club. And he was the one who phoned me pre-season to say, get ready for pre-season, I'm coming home. And he said, you're my captain, get ready, we're gonna win the league again. And thankfully we went on to win the league after that. So just an incredible man as well. I think what people don't see with him as well, he mentioned my kids obviously in that, and he still phones today and, sorry, might have to edit that. An Arsenal shirt, I don't even know whether I should touch this or not. I tell you what, glad it's not a Spurs shirt because I definitely wouldn't be picking it up. Thierry Henry, wow, this man had absolutely everything.
Is there anybody better in the world than Thierry Henry?
I think with his pace and his movement and how clever he was with the timing of his runs, he could literally humiliate you. He was the one player that I genuinely feared. Probably a very early standout moment would be, we're lining up and Marcel spoke to me. He said, JT, leave him with me. Stay close, watch and learn. And honestly, Thierry absolutely terrorised him. And I was kind of playing alongside Marcel thinking, geez, I hope that guy don't come over my side. Just an incredible player. I think it's one of those where you look back and you can tell your kids you played against some of the very best, and he's right up there for me. Captain's armband. Something I'm very proud of, obviously to be captain of Chelsea for so long as well. It's something that meant so much to me, I think because I knew the football club inside out.
John Terry knows when the stage is his.
John Terry, who has led throughout by strong example.
Your captain, your leader, your legend.
From the age of 14, I'd literally done everything. I'd kind of clean the stadium, the old Stamford Bridge, run up and down the stairs and clean the toilets. And to be where kind of we are today and what we've achieved in that 22 years that I was at the football club was just an incredible period. And I think I find myself very lucky.
John Terry has his Hollywood ending, and Chelsea are Premier League champions for the fifth time.
As a captain, I think you have to lead. When you're giving it everything, you can then demand for people around you as well. That's what I wanted to kind of be as a captain. I wanted to be that person that kind of led the way by example. I'm the one with the armband on my arm, you know, leading the team out, but there's many players and people behind that I owe a huge thank you to. I think it's an amazing thing that the Premier League are doing, inducting players throughout their careers into the Hall of Fame, and I'm sure there's going to be many more from my era of players that kind of deserve this as well. So again, just really grateful, and you know, it's been six and a half years now retired. You miss playing, you miss performing in front of people, you miss kind of the rivalry and the camaraderie in the dressing room. But I'd always want to be remembered that watch John Terry. John Terry is a player that gave absolutely everything for his club, for his country and his teammates. And that was certainly me. So to kind of have that recognised by everyone else is what I wanted and what you want to leave as a player. Great to go down memory lane. And we need to get a new photo for sure.